Welcome! In this video we will look at the patcher of FL Studio 20. My name is Mattias and let's take the tour! Yeah, so that's a little preset that I put together here in the patcher of FL Studio. Okay, so what is the patcher? It's a really great plugin within FL Studio where you can layer and create very intricate sound design setups. To create the patcher instrument in FL Studio, you just press the plus sign on our track list and go to the patcher. And we can also expand this view just to get a better overview of this plugin. Okay, so this is the patcher, and in the patcher you patch cables between devices and connect them and create your instruments and sound design setups. So here we can right click and choose add plugin, and let's add a Zebra, and now we can see that our Zebra plugin is connected via a cable from FL. The signal goes from FL and the audio signal will go out from this Zebra plugin and back to FL Studio. So that's a very basic signal flow setup. Okay, so the best way to explain the patcher is probably just to load up one of these great presets that comes with FL Studio. And in the patcher you have two ways of viewing your patch. You have the surface mode and you have the mapping mode. And as we can see here in the mapping, there's quite a lot going on in this preset. We have a lot of controllers and the harmonic going into a fruity EQ, then into a fruity stereo enhancer, sending the audio back to FL Studio. So you can think of the mapping and surface as your back end. The mapping is the back end and the surface is your front end. Okay, so now let's create our own patcher. Load up a patcher within our channel rack here. Then we can route the audio to channel 5. And currently we don't have any signal going to FL, but we will change that by adding a Zebra 2 instance. And now we can add additional instruments if we want and see the signal flow here within the patcher. So let's add a preset from Serum, or create our own preset here in Serum. Now you can see that the MIDI is routed to Zebra 2, and we also have MIDI being routed to the Serum. And then they are both summed and sent back to FL Studio. And within this patcher we can also control how much of each signal is being routed to the back to FL Studio. So we can remove some of the Zebra, or remove the Serum. You can also right-click these cables and disable them. So now we will only hear the Serum. Okay, so let's make this second instrument to an arpeggiator. Or a pulsing sound. So let's connect an LFO to our level. Increase the volume slightly here and do a little bit of filtering. Maybe with a bandpass filter. And have a little bit of modulation on that bandpass filter too. So now we have two instruments that we can control separately how much we want to send to the back to FL mixer. Okay, so maybe we want to add some kind of reverb to this or delay that we want to be able to control with a controller. So let's go in here and add the M Turbo Reverb. Double click on it to open up the plugin, the actual plugin. And let's go to special and add some of the shimmer. Currently it's not connected to any of these devices, but we can easily disconnect all the cables which goes from the plugins to back to FL, and we can connect them to the Turbo Reverb instead. And then we connect the output from the Turbo Reverb back to FL. Okay, so maybe we want to control this Turbo Reverb wetness with the controller. Now we can go into the surface mode of the patcher and add a knob. It's currently not connected, but we disable this wrench icon. Let's go back to our backend for this patch design. Now you can see we have a red little dot here. And if we look at the information panel up here, it says knob 1. And this one says media output. And we want to control the wetness here in the Turbo Reverb. So let's drag the knob controller here to M Turbo Reverb. And as we drop the knob there, we will get access to all the parameters of this Turbo Reverb. But the first one is the wetness, so let's press that and now you can see we have a cable connected to the wetness of the reverb. So now we can control it with this knob. And now I can learn this knob to my controller. We need to activate it. So now that's activated. We first need to activate it and then activate it. And now we go to link to controller and move a controller on our keyboard. I really like this full screen overview because often when you're doing sound design and instrument design, you are focused on one task and that instrument. And then you can, I mean, you don't have to see mixers or other stuff. You only want to see the instrument design and all the modules that goes into this sound design session. And we can also add some EQ after this Turbo Reverb or add some compression. Just to right click this output and insert plugin, maybe a little bit of OTT to compress this, this signal. Right click here and disconnect and route our OTT audio back to FL Studio. And drag down this because OTT can get a little bit too much sometimes. Yeah, so I really like this visual overview within the patcher of FL Studio if you want to create intricate sound design and layered instruments. Yeah, so we will see if we will get a similar solution in Bitwig Studio. Okay, so what do you think about the patcher in FL Studio? If you have any questions on the patcher or how it compares with the horizontal workflow of the devices in Bitwig Studio or Ableton, please shoot me them in the comments and let's get the discussion rolling. My name is Mattias. Now you can continue and watch my next video on vocal mixing techniques in FL Studio. Thanks for watching today and see you in the next video. Bye bye.
Bam! Bam!